Hey guys, this is Modelman and welcome to another episode of Modelman Animation. In my FAQ playlist, I answer the questions that you ask in the comment section of my tutorials. Today we're gonna answer this question. To begin, I'm gonna hit the S key to select the draw shape tool. Next, I select the circle and choose a yellow color to draw, and then I hold down the shift key and drag to draw a yellow circle. And because I want to remember that I have a yellow circle in this layer, I click on here and choose yellow to label my layer with a yellow color. Next, I create a new layer. This time, let's choose a red color. And by holding down the shift key, I draw a red circle here. Then I label this layer with a red color. And this time, I create a new layer, choose a green color, and draw a green circle by holding down the shift key right here. Let's label it with a green color. Then I want to animate them. So first, I select the yellow one, hit the T key to select the transform points tool. Then I go to the frame 24, and by dragging on my circle and holding down the shift key, I can move it to the left horizontally. I select the second layer, move it to the top, and I select the third one, the green one, and move it to the right. Let me play this animation for you. I hit the space. So as you can see, since this layer is selected, if I hold down the shift key and choose the bottom layer, it will select all of the layers. And since we labeled them with a color, now you can see the color of the layers in the timeline window. And also the name of them are visible. The highlighted one, which is actually the brighter one here, shows you the current layer. So all of these parameters that you see here are for layer 1 and not the others. When you select multiple layers, the last layer that you select will be the brighter one and your current layer. Also, selecting multiple layers helps you to see their colors and have the keyframes of all of them at the same time. By moving this slider, you can see all of them. We usually select multiple layers to move the keyframes of them at the same time. See? Also, when you want to match the keyframe of a layer with the other layers, this method is really helpful. See? Note that in this case, we only have 3 layers. We also have a feature called marker. We usually use marker at the start and end of every action that we have to remember that when an action is going to start and when it's going to end. So for example, I can choose the first layer, click on here on the frame 24, and then choose marker. I'm gonna type end. And if you check this option, a line will be added at the place of your playhead. And then when other layers are selected, you will still be able to see the marker. But if you uncheck it, there won't be any line at the place of your playhead. And after that, if you select other layers, you won't be able to see the marker. So since I want to see the marker when other layers are selected, I have to check this and then choose OK. As you can see, every marker is actually a keyframe. You can move it to the right or left. And because we checked that option, now if we select other layers, we still can see the marker. Having a marker doesn't have any effect on the other keyframes. It's just for your own understanding. So now, for example, if I select this one, and then hold on the shift key and select this one, I can now match everything with my marker. See? Let me delete the marker. So now you know that there are 2 ways that helps you match your keyframes with each other. One way is to use marker, the other way is to use selecting multiple layers method. And sometimes you may want to use both of them to set a marker and then match all of them while multiple layers are selected. But there is also another way, and that is timeline visibility. Before I teach it, let me tell you something about the labels. If you change the label to another color, like this, you're not gonna see the result instantly. And the reason is that in order to see the result, you have to move your mouse into this highlighted area that I'm showing to you. As soon as your mouse reaches there, the color of your layers will be updated. So if you change a color here and you don't see the result in your timeline window, that is the reason. Now let's talk about timeline visibility. Every column that you see in layers window has a name. For example, if I right click on here, you can see that we have label, name, quick settings, timeline visibility, and visibility. This is the visibility column. This is the timeline visibility column. This is the name column. This is the label column, and this is the quick settings column. Let me hit Ctrl Z to have my colors back. Now you know that the name of this column is timeline visibility. If we right click on here, we can hide it. And to bring it back, we just have to right click on here and check it again. You can also move this column to the right or left. And now I'm gonna click on here to go back to frame zero. And then I'm gonna choose the second layer and duplicate it. Now if I hold down the shift key and click on layer 2, these three layers will be selected and we can see the keyframes of them and the color of them in timeline window. But here is the thing, as soon as you check timeline visibility for one of the layers that are not selected, like this one, you can see that selecting multiple layers doesn't show you the keyframes and the colors of all of them in your timeline window anymore. So now you know that you only can use the method of selecting multiple layers when there is no check for timeline visibility. Now I'm gonna select this layer, hold down the control, and add this layer to my selection, and then click on delete layer, and select this layer on top. Let's talk about what timeline visibility is. When you use timeline visibility, there are two situations. First, a layer is not selected, and second, a layer is selected. When a layer is not selected, like layer 1, the yellow one, then if you check timeline visibility for it, if it has keyframe, you're gonna see the keyframes of it and the color of it in your timeline window. If it doesn't have any keyframe, you're not gonna see the color of it in your timeline window. Let me hit Ctrl Z and select the top layer again. If you change its color to plain and move your mouse in this highlighted area like this, to update the colors, since we chose plain for it, now there is no color for layer 1. But we still can see its keyframes while other layers are selected. Let me change its color to yellow again. And now I have to move my mouse to here to update the colors. And now let's talk about timeline visibility when a layer is selected, like this one, the green one. In this case that the layer is selected, it doesn't matter if you check timeline visibility for it or not. If you check timeline visibility for at least one of the other layers, like layer 1, then you're gonna see the color of it and the keyframes of it in your timeline window. But if there is no check, only the keyframes of the layer will be visible, and you won't be able to see the color of the selected layer. And if you check timeline visibility for at least one of the other layers and set its color to plain and move your mouse inside the timeline window, again you will have the keyframes of the layer, but there won't be any color for it. Now I'm gonna show you when we use timeline visibility. To start, I'm gonna hit the S key to select the draw shape tool. Then I choose triangle and select the yellow color, and uncheck auto stroke and auto fill because I want to draw a path only, and then I draw it. Then I hit the T key to select transform points tool, and by holding down the control I press C and then V to make a copy of it. Then I scale it, and by holding down the Alt I can scale it from the center. Next I hold down the control and drag to select these two points, and by holding down the shift key I'm gonna move them vertically to here. Next I'm gonna hold down the alt key and drag from here to there to scale these two points symmetrically. Let me hold down the control and click outside of these two points. I think that it's better to move them a little bit lower than this. Here is better. Now I'm gonna hit the U key to select the create shape tool. And then I hit Ctrl A to select all of the points. And while the yellow color is selected, I choose Create Shape. Let me call this layer T, stands for triangle. And then I label it with a yellow color. And because the shape is selected, I can hit Q to select the Select Shape tool and click outside of the shape to deselect it so we can see the shape better. Then I'm gonna hit the T key, hit Ctrl A to select all of its points, and by holding down the Shift key, I'm gonna move it vertically to down here. Next, I'm gonna create a new layer Let's call it S1, stands for shape 1, and hit enter to confirm its name. Next, I'm gonna hit the S key, select circle, and choose a red color for it. And let's also set its label to red. Then I'm gonna check this option and this one, because I want to draw my circle with stroke and fill. And I hold my mouse on here and start dragging. By holding down the Alt, I can draw from the center, and by holding down the Shift, I can draw a circle. I release the click and then release Alt and Shift. To animate this circle, I hit the T key, go to frame 12, and by holding down the Shift key, I move this circle to up here. And as you can see now, we have an animation. It starts from the frame 0. If I wanted to start from any frame other than 0, I have to drag to choose these two keyframes. Then I hit Ctrl C to copy them. After that, I can, for example, click on here and press Ctrl V to paste those keyframes to frame 1. And now I can select all of these keyframes and move this animation to anywhere on my timeline. See? Now the circle is gonna start to move from here. Let me move these keyframes to there and go to frame 0. Next, I duplicate this layer. Let's call it S2 and press enter. And to move the whole layer, I press the M key to select the transform layer tool and then move this circle to here. After that, I go to frame 12 and hit the T key to select the transform tool and move this circle to there. Let's duplicate it again and call this one S3. Press enter, hit the M key, go to frame 0 and move this new layer to there. Then I go to frame 12, hit the T key to select the transform tool and move this circle to there. Now we have an animation like this, see? Next, I'm gonna go to this layer and move these keyframes to there, so the animation of this circle will start from this frame, see? And then I choose this layer and move these keyframes to somewhere around here, see? It's gonna start from here. What we're gonna do is that we wanna move all of the points of this triangle based on the position of these circles. One way is that we can use the marker. But to do that, we have to go to each layer and set a marker for the start of their animation and the end of their animation. So we should add 6 markers. We also have to type a name for our markers to know that which marker belongs to which layer, and it takes a lot of time. Also, having a lot of markers up here is a little bit confusing. Another way is that we can hold on the Shift key and select multiple layers like this. But again, since we have a lot of keyframes here, it's a little bit confusing. Another way is that we can select this layer, hold down the Control and select the first one to match the points of our yellow shape with it. But there is also a problem with this method, and that is you can only change the parameters of the layer that is brighter. And you know that the last layer that you select is brighter. So to match the points of the yellow shape with these 3, we have to first, for example, select this one, then hold down the Control and select the yellow layer. So the last layer, the brighter one, will be the yellow layer. And then we will have the chance to match the points by going to frame 12, hold down the Control and select these two, and move them to up here. Again, we have to select this layer, hold down the Control and select this one. And as you can see, every time you have to remember that the last layer that you select is this layer, unless you won't be able to move the points of the yellow layer. So although this method works, it's a little bit confusing. And the fact that you have to hold down the Control and select and deselect all of these layers and be careful with the last layer that you select makes us realize that it is not the best way. So this is when we have to use timeline visibility. Let me hit Ctrl Z to remove the keyframes that we created for the yellow layer. This time, I'm gonna use timeline visibility method. So first, I'm gonna check this layer and move these 2 points to up here. And because I know that this is the beginning of my animation, I have to copy these 2 keyframes by hitting Ctrl C, and then I click on the first frame and press Ctrl V. Next, I'm gonna check this one and check this one, and then I go to this frame, hold on the Ctrl and select these 2 points. We can add a keyframe for their positions. So I'm gonna right click on here and add a keyframe because this is where our circle starts to move. Then I'm gonna click on here and move these 2 points to there. Next, I uncheck this one and check this one. Click on here, hold on the Ctrl and select these 2 keyframes. I right click on the red channel and choose add keyframe because this is where our circle starts to move. And then I click on here and move these 2 points to there. Now let me remove this check. And as you can see, using timeline visibility saves you a lot of time. And in some situations, such as this example, it is much faster to use it than the other methods. Let me go back to frame 0 and hit the space to play this animation for you. Although timeline visibility method is really helpful, you may want to uncheck all of them after you use it. So now, for example, if I want to make this animation faster, selecting multiple layers is the best method. So I hold down the Shift key and select the top layer to select all of the layers. And let me check to see all of them are selected or not. I'm going to click on somewhere to deselect all of the keyframes. Then I drag to select all of these keyframes. By holding down the Shift, you can add to your selection. Now, if I hold down the Alt and drag, I can make my animation faster. So now if we play it, you can see that it became faster. So using selecting multiple layers method, or the marker method, or the timeline visibility method, is completely depend on the situation that you are in. That's it, guys. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. I choose the best ones for this playlist and I answer them in a video like this. I'll be glad if you like and share, subscribe for more videos, and see you in the next episode.